We're going to be doing a demo lesson today about digital citizenship. The lesson plan that I'm going to show you will also be in the video description. So you're free to take it, modify it, use it however you'd like. And really my intention with the lesson today is to talk a little bit about the program. So I'll show you some of the behind the scenes. I'll take questions about any of the programs that I'm using. And then I'm also going to show you what it looks like from the student end. The lesson that we're going to look at is going to embed some different programs. And this was another thing that I wanted to show, how you could take some different programs and strategically sequence them together. There are some different activities in this lesson that you could do asynchronously, and I'll point those out. I got this awesome autumn themed template from Slides Carnival. They have these really cool, beautiful templates, and they brought in some images from Unsplash, which is a great place to get pictures that you have copyright access to. I always start out a lesson with an essential question, and then I go into learning targets. The essential question for this lesson is going to be about sponsored content. So we're going to learn about what sponsored content is and how it relates to digital citizenship. And then when I'm making learning targets for students, I will often break them up into content-based learning targets as well as skill-based learning targets. One of the content-based learning targets would be for students to be able to describe how they could identify sponsored content, and then we'll also have them be able to actually apply that and identify some articles, some websites that have sponsored content on them. And for skill development, students are going to be working on answering comprehension questions on a grade level text, a nonfiction text. Then what they'll be producing to show their knowledge is an instructional video that we're going to make in Flipgrid today. Then we're going to move into the engage phase of a lesson. I want to see what students already know about this concept of sponsoring something, and we're going to build that knowledge in Whiteboard.fi. Whiteboard.fi is essentially a personal whiteboard program that you can access digitally. It's quite different from a program like Jamboard because it is individual and you have a lot more control. Each time you create a class, you're just going to essentially create a new whiteboard, and then you can download it later if you want to see what you created, but it's not a program where students need to create accounts or anything like that. So what I'm going to do here is set up a new class. Now you can enable a waiting room for students. I would recommend you do this. And this mode is going to be beneficial if you have students that have slower internet connections because it will not constantly be saving their document. It's just going to help with speed. And that's just going to give me here a class code that I can give to students. I'm going to set up my own board here first. So I'm going to go here to toggle my whiteboard. One option, if you want to create a graphic organizer in here, is that you make it directly in Whiteboard.fi. You could also bring an image in, so you could create a background in something like Google Slides. I'm going to grab this shapes tool. Then what I'm going to do is just copy and paste that a couple of times. Then what I'm going to do up top is add a text box to explain what would be in this particular part of the graphic organizer. I've done that. Now, what I actually want to do here is make this whole thing into a background by clicking this flatten image icon. And that's going to turn this entire graphic organizer now into the background. If you look at this eraser tool, this also allows you to do something like keep the foreground or clear the foreground, but keep the background. You'll see that there's a couple ways students can get in. So there's a QR code here. There's also just a room code that they can enter. So here for the room code, they'll enter the same code. They're going to enter their name. And then when they enter their name, I'm going to be able to see on my end. So if I go here and toggle, that I have a lobby and I have students waiting in the lobby. that I can let in. Then you'll see that I'm able to see the student's whiteboard on my screen. I have to tell them explicitly to toggle the teacher whiteboard here. So when they click toggle teacher whiteboard, they're going to see that whiteboard that I've already created. If I click toggle my whiteboard, then I will see mine and I can also see the student whiteboards below. I could tell students, you're going to say what you already know about the word sponsor. That's going to show up on the student board. If I want them to be able to use this graphic organizer, what I can do here is actually push the graphic organizer out to the student board. And I'm going to push it to them as the background. And they will have my teacher board with the graphic organizer on their board that they can write on. I can see that. And obviously you can imagine that you have a bunch of students. You can see those answers coming through. I can go to actions. And then what I can do is I can push this. So I'm going to push, copy the student answer to the teacher whiteboard. It's going to show up now on the whole board. And we're going to go into the explore phase. Students are going to start to learn new content. Actively Learn is awesome. If you have not checked it out, I definitely recommend that you do. What I'm going to do here is set up a class, and you can either bring in a class from Google Classroom or you can just bring in your own. In this case, since I'm not bringing it in from Google Classroom, what it's going to do is just generate a code that I can share with students. And that's going to allow you to do some pretty powerful report tracking of student data. You'll see there's a huge library of content, so you can look based on curriculum, units and topics, news articles, things like that. They also have fiction on Actively Learn. So I'm going to pull up this article, Can You Identify Sponsored Content? What you'll notice here is that every article on Actively Learn already has these interactive questions embedded into the article. And these are fully editable. So if you don't want that there, you could delete that question. I can just highlight a part of the text, click insert question, and there I can either write a short answer question or I could create a multiple choice question. So I'm going to assign this now. I'll assign it to my demo class. Okay, so the student is going to go up here to the add button and click join class. And then they'll enter that code just like they did with WhiteboardPHI. There you'll see that they have the article pop directly up in their assignment portal. A couple of things here. One, if they highlight a word, and let's say they're unsure what advertisements means, they can pull up a definition of that word. They can listen to
advertisement.
The word. They can also translate the word. Or another thing I like about Actively Learn is the fact that it stops the student from moving forward as they're reading. So student is reading, they come to this question that they have to answer. They can't just blow past it. They have to answer the question in order to be able to proceed. These, once students start doing the assignments, you're going to be able to pull up some pretty rich information about all the standards alignments of the questions. You know, you can pull up all the data about specific questions that students got right and wrong. And it's all going to come in for you live as well. So now we're going to take it up a notch. We're going to have students apply that learning. And I love Padlet for this. Allows students, allows you to basically post any type of media to a Padlet board, which is what I really like about it. Mostly I see the shelf and the wall being used, but you can do mind mapping and make digital interactive maps and stuff like that. I'm going to set up a shelf here. What we're going to do here is set up this Padlet. So it says sponsored content. And it's going to be a little workspace here. I would recommend that you turn on attribution, that you have students create free accounts so that their names show up. What I'm going to do here with the first column is have students post about what they learned in the article. We're going to have students go out and actually find a web page on the internet that has some sponsored content in it. Then we could also have them post a page without sponsored content. One of the benefits of creating these columns where students essentially have to work in progression is that it gives students things to do. So one student finishes with this, well, they can move on to the next one. You can be commenting, leaving feedback as they're kind of moving in progression through the work. I'm just going to go up here to share. I'll copy the link. So a student here could put that, you know, what they learned. They'll see a little awaiting approval because I turned on that notification. So if another student were to log in, they're not going to see that answer. I can choose to approve it. Once I approve yours, then that means it's okay to move on to the next column. One thing in the settings that I forgot to do was enable the comments function. One thing I can do as students are then moving on, right, is I can add a comment. So let's say that a student finds that, they're going to copy that link. Rather than the text tool, they'll go to the link tool here. They'll put the URL, write the name of the webpage, and how they know that it has sponsored content. What I do like about doing something like this with students all together is that it allows you to give that formative feedback to students. You can correct any misunderstandings right in the moment. Now students are going to elaborate on what they learned. Here we'll have them apply that learning in a deeper way where they really have to, you know, in some cases work individually, in some cases work in a group, but they have to do something that shows that they've learned that information. Flipgrid is a tool. It's basically just a program that allows you and students to post short videos and respond to each other in video format. What we're going to have students do in Flipgrid here is create a video that is teaching about what they learned. Set up a group really quickly. When you're creating one for students, you're going to want to make it private. Set this all up so that they have to log in with student emails. For topics, these are basically assignments. And when you want to create one, you go over here to add a topic, and then you can add a title. What they'll have to do here is create an instructional or explanatory video. Your videos are going to be better if you give kids really specific criteria. You might have them give an example so they could talk about an example that they saw either another student post. You could also add an element that we haven't really brought in yet, and that's to share your opinion about sponsored content. You can change the recording time here. You can add all kinds of different media. Recording a video is a really great idea. So you can basically just record a video prompt of yourself explaining the assignment. You can also just do things like bring in images or GIFs, things like that. I want to add this topic to a group so that I've assigned it. So I'm gonna add this to my demo class, Digital Citizenship. I can share this information again with students. There's a join code, and I can share this join code. So you'll see here that this student has already joined a class, right? But in this case, I'm just going to enter that same join code. The student will see the prompt. They'll see the assignment. And obviously, if I made a video or anything like that, they'd be able to make their video here. So a student, right, can have their screen up. There are all these different options as well. So they can actually bring in other clips. They can, you know, make a video somewhere else, bring that clip in, bring in notes. The effects tool is probably the one that they're going to use the most often. So they have different filters, can filter the video in different ways. For shy students, they can use this pixelation tool if they wanted to. So this is a lot of this is just kind of fun stuff. They have a text tool so that they could actually type right directly on here. What a student would do when they're ready is click on the red record and they'll talk about what they are talking about. So when the student's ready, they click on the red record and they'll talk about what that was like an edit screen. Okay, then it's gonna pull up a little thumbnail image. They click submit. Once that video is posted, you will be able to see that directly in the assignment. Now that the student has posted, I'm able to see the student response that you were just on the hearing. Red record in the background. And Students, when they log in, can also watch each other's videos and they can respond to each other. It doesn't have to be a video response. They can also respond just with a text comment. You can as well. Last section now, which is the evaluate section. Now, traditionally, evaluate is going to be a quiz or a test, and you could absolutely turn something like this into a more traditional evaluation where you're having students take a quiz and show, you know, apply that learning in that kind of format. I also like to do evaluation in different ways. One of those strategies is to do peer evaluation. You could have it be more formal where they actually have to fill in a rubric and communicate that feedback. You could also have it be just more of an informal evaluation where you're having students go in, they have to watch two of their classmates' responses here on Flipgrid. And if you really wanted to control it, you could even assign who has to watch whose specific video. What they'll do when they respond is name something that they found interesting, and then they could also essentially name a plus and a delta. So what's something you did well, and what's something that you could improve upon.